good afternoon to everyone. As introduced, I'm known as Budget Diva on YouTube and on Instagram. And I talk about money matters. And my target audience is mainly young professionals. But I also have quite a bit of a following from the student crowd, which is what I'm told I'll be speaking to today. And when I engage with people online, I primarily speak to people between the age of 27 to about 31, and I speak to two consistent themes of people that slide in my DM, because no one really wants to ask a question on a YouTube channel, so they'll generally send you an inbox. So the first type of people are people that are saying, I'm earning a salary, but I don't know what to do with it. So it's as if like they don't even know where to start in terms of how to play around with their money. So all they do is just spend, and eventually everything else will fall into place. The second category of people are people that sort of knew what they were doing, but somehow, somewhere, they managed to get themselves in a situation where they're sort of living on a maxed out budget. And at the core of all of this is a lot of people somewhat didn't know how to handle money before they started in earning. And I believe if I had to turn back the wheel of time, I'll probably take myself back to university and invest a little bit more time in understanding money matters in general. Because for a lot of us, it is really at university where we have our first encounter with money, because that's when we get like allowances from parents, bursaries, NASFA, as well as siblings. So today I'm going to be speaking about budgeting and saving in context of a student life. So I don't know why a lot of people tend to complicate budgeting in a nutshell, but at the very core of it is really just you understanding money that is coming in and money that is flowing out, and also just living on the overriding principle that you can never spend, or you should never, not you can never, you should never spend more than you earn. Because if you're spending more than you earn, it means that you are spending your future income, which is what my fellow speaker spoke about here. For a lot of young professionals, this means you get yourself into consumer debt, the likes of, you know, overdraft credit cards that you use to fund the lifestyle. But for a student, it is as simple as saying, you know what, people are going out tonight, I don't have money, can you please borrow me 300, I'll pay you back when my allowance comes in. What that does to your income is when your money comes in, it's no longer worth what it was supposed to do, because you now need to pay back X and Y before you can start spending. So that is really the core of budgeting. And today here, I just want to look at sort of like income streams for a student. It will probably be your allowance from your parents, from your siblings. If you have a bursary, maybe your monthly allowance from the bursary, and the favorite of all, the NASFA refund. And your expenses would be just your allowance, your cosmetics on a monthly basis. Maybe at the beginning of the year, you might have textbooks here and there. And then if you're not in rest, perhaps you have your accommodation that you need to pay. So that is the basic expenses of your student life. And what you can really do as a student is really just learn to distinguish between what's a want and what's a need of those expenses. And also understanding that we are currently living in high inflationary times. The things we're able to buy with your allowance from last year is probably not the same as what you could buy this year. So it will come with sacrifices. And sacrifices don't have to be like massive sacrifices. It could be as simple as last year, because inflation wasn't so bad, you were able to afford a shower gel. Therefore, that's what you used to buy. This year, things are unfortunately tough. Shower gels are nearly the price of what they were costing last year. So perhaps switching to a bubble bath, because it does the same job and it lasts longer. So it's just really learning to make those minor adjustments to make sure that you are making it through the month. So that is the first aspect of expenses and just getting through the month. The second thing that you then need to look at when it comes to budgeting is, what tool are you going to use to budget? So a lot of people, because you are a student, you don't have that many expenses and categories of expenses, so your budget doesn't look as complex. So you can do it in a notebook where you literally are listing, this is my income, this is my expenses. If you are Excel savvy, even better, you can build a little bit table in an Excel, and then you can put your income and your expenses in Excel. But most importantly, if you are just planning what you are budgeting, but you're not reflecting what you did with the money at the end of the day, it's actually pointless. Because it's only when you sit and critically evaluate at how have you spent your money versus what you plan to do it, you actually realize the root cause analysis of where your money leaks are, and hopefully in the next cycle you get to fix that. And lastly, I want to touch a little bit on savings, which would actually touch a little bit with what my previous presenter spoke about. But as a student, really, you don't have that much of an income. But a lot of you guys really do have spending cycles where in January your spending is very high because you need to buy expensive textbooks, stationery, etc. But in the middle of the year, there's nothing happening there. So there is a little bit of room in your budget in the middle of the year to put some money aside, maybe for a rainy day. And for a student, a rainy day could literally be your grandmother passing away in the north, and all you need is $400 to go on a bus to get to the north to attend your grandmother's funeral. But if you don't have that $400 saved aside, you're going to start calling your friends fake friends because no one is going to come through for you in the middle of the month. So that is what we are talking about for a student. And if you build that discipline of putting money aside when you are a student, it will come naturally when you start working. Because if you can't handle the little you have, believe me, you are going to get that salary no matter how much it is, and you are going to struggle with the very same problem. And also just learning institution where to save your money. And we all had here, you can't really get wealthy quickly. And for some odd reason, students that don't even make money, they will risk their NASDAQ refund with a forex trader, the head of the internet. They hear there is another pyramid scheme, then you are putting all you really have there. So make sure when you are saving, you are doing it with a reputable institution. And for students, already you are looking for is capital protection. We can deal with, you know, capital appreciation later when you have the money and when you have accumulated a little bit. So the good thing with putting your money with reputable institution, which is your asset managers, your bank, etc., you are guaranteed that when you wake up tomorrow, your money is likely to be exactly what you invested in, plus a little bit of a return, minus any charges that they are on that account. And for many banks, they also offer student account where there's minimum to zero bank charges. So learn to put your money in the right institution so that you don't lose the little that you're trying to accumulate. And in conclusion here, I just want to say really, when it comes to handling your finances as a student, don't take it lightly. I've had friends that walked out of university with savings ready to put up as a car deposit when they started working. Where did they get that money? They put aside a portion of their NASDAQ refund, a portion of their parents' allowances, and they got side hustles that wasn't interfering with their studies. We are not saying go and pick up a stupid role at the club and you are now not attending class because you are hungover. No. We are saying do something that will allow you to finish your study and still enable you to meet your financial needs while putting a little bit aside. And I've also had friends that have worked out of university with fancy phones, fancy camera, good travel memory, but nothing to show for because that's the lifestyle they choose. But all of that is determined by your attitude towards money, and that is what you are setting yourself up when you eventually started working. So really, this is all I had from the discussion. You can follow me. I talk a lot, mainly geared to young professional, but I also have a bit of other videos on students, including how to spend your last refund. I like it because you guys really listen. Thank you very much.